To demonstrate the properties of logarithms, we're asked to write the sum of these two logs as a single log, and the difference of these two logs as a single log. So because we're trying to combine a sum of two logs here, we'll be using the product property of logarithms given here, where log base b of x times y is equal to log base b of x plus log base b of y. So if we want to combine the sum of two logs into a single log, there are two things we should notice. First, the bases must be the same. And then because we have a sum to combine the two logs, we're going to multiply the number of parts of the logarithms as a single log. So for log base 3 of 4x squared y plus log base 3 of 5x cubed y squared, this will be equal to log base 3 of 4x squared y times 5x to the third y squared. So we have combined this into a single log, but we do want to find this product here. So this will equal log base 3 of 4 times 5 is 20, x to the second times x to the third is x to the fifth, and y to the first times y to the second is y to the third. We have now combined this sum of two logs into a single log. Looking at the second example, notice how we have a difference. So we'll be using the quotient property of logarithms here. We have log base b of x divided by y equals log base b of x minus log base b of y. So again, what we should notice here is that if we have a difference of two logs and the bases are the same, then because we have a difference of two logs this time, we can combine them into a single log if we find the quotient of x and y. So for our second example, because we have a difference and the bases are the same, we can write this as log base 7 of 3x to the fourth y to the third divided by 5x to the sixth y to the third. So we have combined this into a single log, but we do want to simplify this fraction as much as possible. Notice we have y to the third over y to the third, that simplifies to 1. And then we have x to the fourth over x to the sixth. Notice how there are two more factors of x in the denominator. So when we simplify this, the x to the fourth would simplify out, the x to the sixth would simplify to x to the second. The 3/5 does not simplify, so this would be log base 7 of 3 over 5x to the second. Taking a closer look at x to the fourth divided by x to the sixth, there are several ways to simplify this. Because we have a quotient, we could subtract the exponents. 4 minus 6 is equal to negative 2, and x to the negative 2 is equal to 1 over x squared. Notice how we still have two factors of x in the denominator, as we do here. As a last resort, we could just expand this. There'd be 4 factors of x on top, and 6 factors of x on the bottom. Every x over x simplifies to 1, so that simplifies to 1, 1, 1, 1. Either way, we end up with 2 factors of x in the denominator, or x squared in the denominator. Okay, I hope you found this helpful.